A Walker County family fights to prove that a father of three was murdered, even though investigators ruled his death a suicide.
Donald Edward Fickey Jr. was found dead with a shotgun wound to his face. Family members hired a private investigator and say they have the evidence to prove this case needs to be looked at again. Channel 3's Natalie Potts shares their story. Natalie.
Well, Cindy, family members say DJ Fickey was with at least two other people at the time of his death, his wife and a family friend who called 911. They say there are just too many inconsistencies in that friend's story that point to foul play.
I can't sleep at night. I cry myself to sleep every night, even to this day.
Amanda Shirley says she cannot understand why investigators closed her brother's case.
His father died when he was 14, and so he knew what it was like to grow up without a daddy, and he would never do that to his kids.
She shared a 911 call included in the evidence collected by the Walker County Sheriff's Office. You can hear the caller report moving the gun DJ Fickey allegedly shot himself with.
I got the gun up and checked to see what it was. It was a 12 gauge.
Okay, so you moved the gun, is that correct?
Yes.
Investigators noted in their reports that the caller changed his story multiple times and failed a polygraph test. According to those reports, he said he was in another room at the time of the shooting. He later told detectives he was wrestling DJ for the gun when it fired. DJ's wife told a different story.
She seen the person of interest come out of the bedroom angrily, point the gun at my brother, called him a name, and he shot him.
The GBI determined DJ's death to be a suicide. The district attorney's office said there was not enough evidence in the case to file charges. Shirley says she will never give up.
They're never going to know him. He's never going to be here for birthday parties and Christmases and Halloween to walk his twin daughters down the aisle. What's right is right and wrong is wrong, and this is not right.
Now, the Walker County Sheriff's Office and District Attorney Buzz Franklin have not returned our calls today. A spokesperson for the GBI says the case was reviewed and they stand by their initial ruling. DJ's family has hired a private investigator who was pushing for the case to be reopened because gunshot residue tests were never done to determine if DJ fired a gun. Live in the studio, Natalie Potts, Channel 3 Eyewitness News.